Are you still loving it?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah?
Definitely.
Good, good. Yeah. It must be such a thrill and a joy to discover new voices, to
yes.
discover new talent.
Yeah, I love it. I mean, I'm like that anyway.
Yeah, you're always on the lookout for new talent.
I've always been listening to what's happening and what's sure. what's coming out, you know. So I'm always interested in listening to new singers.
Sure.
So this, being on The Voice, is a perfect vehicle for me.
It was a dream job. It was a match made in heaven. It really was. Mm. Ollie Murs has joined. How's he doing?
He's doing great.
Yeah?
He's very natural. He's, you know, what you see is what you get with Ollie, and that's a great thing.
Yeah.
You know, because he's a very up person.
Mm.
And you need that.
No, you do. He's very fizzy. Mm. And also, I suppose, he's had the experience of being in... I know it was X Factor, it wasn't The Voice, but he's had the experience of being on that sort of show. He'll be able to identify with all the worries and the concerns that the contestants have got as well. So
that's right,
makes
exactly.
sense.
And Jennifer as well, you see, because
Of course.
She came from that.
She
you know,
sure did.
In the States.
What a voice she's got.
Unbelievable.
It's unbelievable. Yeah.
She's a full-on soul singer.
Oh,
you know?
Completely, completely. It's just incredible. All of you performing there, that was mm-hmm. great. That must be really good to do that as well. You're not just sitting there judging.
No.
You're actually performing as well.
Yes. And we have some fun, you know, we sort of sing a little bit in between if something happens.
Yeah.
If the feeling takes us.
It's really relaxed, isn't it?
Exactly.
Very relaxed.
It's a very happy show. You know, we all get on so well together and we're all in it for the same reason.
Of course.
To help other people.
And then it gets a little bit competitive as well, though.
Well, when you hear somebody that you really like and you want them to be on your team,
absolutely.
Then you've got to compete with the other coaches, you know, because you want that person yourself.
Sure.
But we all feel the same way, that if we hear somebody that we think, I think I can really do something for that person, you know, he or she really speaks to me.
Mm.
I can hear what's in them. So that's when we fight a little bit to get them on.
To hang on to. Now, you need to tell me about the hip replacement.
Yep.
How is it doing? Because obviously you are renowned for the hip movement.
That's right.
And we didn't want that to stop.
No, exactly.
No.
I think I just wore it out.
It was worn out.
It was worn out.
After all the years.
I don't have a new one.
I know. So is it okay? Is everything all right?
It's fantastic.
Yeah.
Because I walk most days, you know, get out and walk. Mm. And now I don't feel it. It's like nothing ever happened.
God,
you know,
amazing.
when you first get it done, you feel it a little bit. You know, you feel that something's happened there. But now it's thank God.
It's all fine. It's
right as rain.
It's all good. So that's the thing about you. You keep really... You're young at heart, completely young at heart. I mean, you were talking earlier on about how you still listen to modern music. You want to. Mm. You're not stuck back in the past. So easily could be, but you're not at all.
No.
And you've got to have that sort of hunger and that love of music.
Yeah. That's what keeps me going.
Of course.
You know, people say, well, why are you still singing? Because I love to sing.
Yeah.
And I love to listen to what's going on. You know, you can't be stuck in the, as you just said.
No.
You know, unless you want to be. Some people just like what they did when they started, and they do the same thing and the same thing.
Mm.
I like to... you know, carry on and compete and listen and be in it.
Well, that's what makes you who you are. That's what's really good. What was all this about you maybe going back to Wales? You were thinking about maybe going back home, or
No, I've come back to the United Kingdom.
Yeah.
You know, so and of course Wales is not far from London.
From anywhere.
Cardiff is only, you know,
I know,
2 hours on.
Very,
on the...
very, very close to your heart, I know.
Yes, yes. South Wales, I mean.
I know, when you go home, it must be... Do you just kind of feel, it's that sort of relief?
Yeah,
home.
you get that feeling. You know, when I go across the bridge there and it says, welcome to Wales.
You say, yay!
Yeah.
I'm home,
yeah.
I'm back.
Yeah.
You were in this time last year. I can't believe it's been a whole year. The year has zoomed past, hasn't it? And obviously we were talking about the loss of Linda, of your wife.
Yeah.
How are you now? How are you now? Because I know it doesn't get any easier and you don't... But you sort of learn to live with it, I guess.
Yeah, you learn to live with it. It's quite right. I mean, that's when it happened. It was a shock.
It's awful, yeah.
You know, it was so sudden. You know, she had lung cancer, but we didn't know until it was too late, really. And that was a big shock. But you have to learn to live with it. And as time goes on, with family and friends help, they help you come through it. You know, because You need that. Yeah. You need help from family and friends, especially. And that's it. So you try to remember the good times that you've had together, you know, and that's it. But she's with me. She'll always be with me.
Well, she were together since you were babies, just about, right?
Yeah, we grew up together. We were kids together.
Absolutely.
You know, we were teenagers when we got married. So, you know, she's still a big part of me.
Still with you. Still with you. Me.